What time is it to go to the dentist? When it's tooth hurty. Ba-da-da-boom! This video, Telling and Writing Time, is an excerpt from one of the videos in my series, What Math Should My First Grader Know? The videos, which cover the first grade math curriculum, are geared for parents to help their first grader. This complete video, as well as the other videos in the series, can be seen on the website listed on the screen. All of the videos have closed captions in English, Spanish, Portuguese, or Haitian Creole. This video, Telling and Writing Time, has closed captions in Spanish. The digital clock is much easier to read, but it's important for the first graders to become comfortable telling time with the analog clock also. So in looking at the analog clock, students can maybe be introduced first just to one of the hands, just to the shorter hand, the hour hand, and it can be explained to students that when this hour hand is pointing right at a number, that's the time that it is. So that, for instance, this would be 12, and we use the word o'clock afterwards. So this would be exactly 12 o'clock. And then when the hour hand is moved to the next number, that would be 1 o'clock. And we can explain to the students that it does not become 2 o'clock until we actually reach the next number. And this is very important for the students to know, because once we introduce the minute hand, this can become a confusing concept, which I'll show in a minute or so. And then moving the hour hand down, this would be 3 o'clock. And if we were looking at a digital clock, we would have 3 would represent the number of hours, and the 2 zeros would represent the number of minutes. So this would mean that it's 3 o'clock. It's the hour of 3 and no minutes past 3. And now I've introduced the minute hand also. So the red hand is the hour hand. The blue hand is the minute hand. And sometimes we hear the students refer to the big hand and the small hand, or this is the shorter hand and the longer hand. So this shorter hand is the hour hand, and the longer hand is the minute hand. And maybe if some students get confused, they can think of the word hour as being shorter than the word minute. Therefore, the hour hand is the shorter hand, the smaller hand, and the minute hand is the longer hand. So now using both the hour and the minute hand, we can explain to the first graders that when this hour hand, just like we said before, when we're using just one hand, is right on the 1, it is 1 o'clock. And when it's 1 o'clock, the minute hand is all the way to the top of the clock on the 12. So this would be 1 o'clock. And then it does not become 2 o'clock until the hour hand is actually on the 2. And what happens in reality, as we know, when we go from 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock, as the minute hand goes around the clock, the hour hand slowly moves from 1 to 2. When the minute hand makes it halfway around the clock, the hour hand is 1/2 of the way to the next hour. You can do the same thing. One more hour. It's going to go, the minute hand is going to go all the way around. When it reaches 12, we now have 3 o'clock. And just like we had before in our digital clock here, 3 o'clock would be represented by the hour of 3 and no minutes past 3 o'clock. Now to introduce the half hours to the student, let me just divide our clock in half here. And when this minute hand goes halfway around the clock, we can read this clock in 2 different ways. We can say half past 3. In other words, this minute hand is half of the way around the clock. And the other way we can read this is that it's 3:30. When the minute hand goes halfway around the clock, it's 30 minutes past the hour. And on the digital clock, the way we would see it is 3:30. And this means that it's 30 minutes past the hour of 3. So this digital clock and this analog clock represents the exact same time. One thing that's difficult for many of the first graders when they see this time on an analog clock is to know if it's 3:30, half past 3, or 4:30, or half past 4. And as I was saying earlier, we want to make sure that the first graders understand that we haven't reached that 4 o'clock hour until the hour hand actually reaches 4. So from 3 o'clock all the way as the minute hand goes around the clock, we're in that 3 o'clock hour, and we've not reached 4 o'clock until the minute hand actually gets back up to the 12. So when the hour hand is halfway between 3 and 4, we want to make sure that the first graders know that this is 3:30 or half past 3.